It doesn't seem to me like it's enough. It's just not enough. It's just not enough.
Dirty, dirty chameleon porn. However, even in the chameleon world, there is denial. Notice as this suave motherfucker bobs his head left and right, instigating her for some sexy time. However, they are denied. She is definitely not in the mood. This would be the sign of a non-receptive chameleon. Enough of your shenanigans, she says. Time to leave. So tell me, miss. Miss, ma'am, what is it exactly about that chameleon that you were not attracted to him? I mean, look at him. He's a stud. All blue, all big, all man. Perhaps not a good day. Well, let's bring you back to your house. We'll try again in a week. Another stunner. Another stunning male. What about him? Would you like to meet with him? He's hung like a pack mule. Apparently not. Here we are. Back to our cage. We'll go interview the suitor and see exactly what the problem was. Here's another victim of circumstance. Pregnant and pregnant again. Oh yes, pardon me, Mr. Blue. A few questions. Why exactly were you denied sexy time from her? Mr. Blue. What was it that your style did not allow for her to find you attractive? Did you have bad breath? Did you forget to shower today? What was the problem, sir? Oh, calm down. A stunning specimen. How could the ladies deny him? Well endowed. Look at him, stretching out, crying to God. Why? Why won't she love me? Oh, the humanity. No worries, sir. We have another female in the waiting. Now, what we were just trying to meet was a Nosey Be Blue, which would be him, and a Nosey Faley female. However, right here, if she would just turn herself this way, right here we have, let's see, usually the camera will eliminate the screen. I don't know how it, yep, there it goes. This would be his girlfriend, a true Nosey Be Blue female. She's an F1. She's one nice lovely step away from wild caught. parents were wild caught, so she was born in captivity, but her parents were wild caught. And wild caught babies usually turn out to be something quite impressive. To give you an example of this impressiveness, this is my 6-month-old Ndappa, which is almost the same size of my 2-year-old Nosey Be Blue. And he was obviously, like I said, his parents were wild. And if you look down here, I'll just have to unzoom this, sorry about that. Down here is my 6-month-old, let's see if we can get him to come out, or turn himself to the side. Is my 6-month-old Red Bar Ambalobi, who was not a F1. However, he is a Cammers baby, so his colors are going to turn out exquisitely when he gets older. But you can definitely see a major size difference. And he's in a small cage, the other one's in a bigger cage. And that's basically it. The parents of him are here. I'll show you them. If you'll just go for a moment. This is over here in this cage, who is actually pregnant right now as we speak. This is Pandora. See if I can get through that screen. Yes, we can. That's Pandora right there. She is currently got a couple eggs in her, which is a leftover mating from the father of him, because this is the second time she's been bred with the father, and she's just laying her third clutch of eggs from the father, which would be my man right here, Rex. Rex is a purebred camera boy. There you are, Rexy. Sexy Rexy. Red is a stallion. So, that's the story with Rex. But those two had those babies. And actually, if you come over here real quick, she also had another clutch with Gabe over here. Gabe is a red-bodied blue bar Ambalobi. He is a stunner, especially when he's all fired up. Look at that face. So freaking handsome. You so sexy. Hi, baby. Look at that package. Woo! Man, packing some man meat down there, bro. No wonder. 2 clutches eggs. Yeah, Gabe is a champion among champions. But, I've reached my YouTube upload limit. So, thank you for tuning in to my almost mating video that turned into a little bit of a display. Remember, kids, brush your teeth.